Before we're gonna start, we're gonna do a quick, because it's the first time we're gonna do we're doing a Gemara Shiur in here. Not Hashem, it's gonna be once a week. Not Hashem. And we're gonna do a quick overview. What is the Gemara and where it came from? So we know we spoke in Simchat Torah about the Torah, of course. And we spoke that we received the Torah in Har Sinai, we received the Chamisha Chumshei Torah and the Ten Commandments, the tablets. But also we get the Oral Torah, Torah Shebe'al Peh, together with the written Torah, Torah Shebichtav. And this Torah is coming in the Mishnah in Masechet Avot. We read it after Pesach, Moshe kibel Torah Misinai, Sarah Yeshua, Yeshua Leskenim, Leskenim Nevi'im. The Mishnah describe what was the order of the receiving the Torah. The Torah Shebichtav, we know, we have the Torah Shebichtav, we have a book, we have here in Sefer Torah, in the Aron. And that's it, this is the same Torah, it stays like this, never changed, Baruch Hashem, and never will change. And the Torah Shebe'al Peh, it's Torah that Kadosh Baruch Hu say to Moshe by mouth, without written. And Moshe, it's passed it to Yehoshua, Yehoshua to the Zkenim, to the elders, and Zkenim and Levi'im to the prophets. Levi'im, Le'an Shek Nes HaGdolah. Shek Nes HaGdolah was 120 people that used to sit in Knesset HaGdolah. They made a lot of takanot for us. For example, the tefillah that we pray every day, this is the tefillah that Anshei Knesset HaGdolah made for us. So they was before the Tanaim era. Tanaim, this is the era that after Anshei Knesset HaGdolah, it started with the Zugot, the pairs, that was Zugot that used to lead Am Yisrael in that time. The most known among them is Hillel and Shammai. We know, everyone know Bet Hillel, Bet Shammai. So this was actually the last pair in this era. And then start the era of Tanaim. So Tanaim, they started when Bet HaMikdash was built. And in the middle of this era, Bet HaMikdash destroyed. In the time of Rabban Yochanan ben Zakkai, Rabbi Akiva, and it's end with Rabbi Yehuda Hanasid. He was the last one, the last president in the time of the Tanaim. Right after the Tanaim, come the era of the Amoraim. So the Amoraim, most of them that we know, used to live in Babel, in Iraq, what we know today. Some of them used to live in Israel, and they write the Talmud Yerushalmi. But we today, and usually we deal mostly with Talmud Bavli, because it's more understandable, and most of the halachot that we have, they be taken from the Talmud Bavli. So we're gonna deal more with Tanaim and the Amoraim in this shiur, because it's gonna start with the Mishnah. Mishnah, it's a work of Tanaim, that of course it was by mouth from father to son, from rabbi to the students. But then in the end of this era, Rabbi Yehuda Hanasid, he was the president, he was in the time before the last exile from Eretz Israel. He understand and he realized that if it's gonna stay like this by mouth, it's gonna be forgotten. No one going to remember this Torah Shebe'al Peh, and we're gonna lose a lot of things. Most of the things, actually, all of the mitzvot that we have is from Torah Shebe'al Peh. From Torah Shebichtav, you can't understand even one mitzvah. So we don't gonna have Yahadut, Judaism at all without Torah Shebe'al Peh. So he decided to write all the Torah Shebe'al Peh. Even that it's Isur from the Torah, it's love, it's Avera from the Torah to write Torah Shebe'al Peh, but he say, Et la'asot la'ashem aferu Torotecha. Because now it's a time for HaKadosh Baruch Hu. If not this, we don't gonna have any Torah. So I prefer to do this avera, do this thing, to write Torah Shebe'al Peh, and in order that we will have all the Torah even today. So today, 2,000 years after, and we have all the Torah Baruch Hashem. And then from the Tanaim, they write all the Mishnah, six darim of the Mishnah, come the Amoraim, one era after, and they did a big work on Shiur Gemara Mishnah, because Shiur Gemara Mishnah, it was very, very shrink. It shrink all Torah Shebe'al Peh inside these six Sedarim. So the Amoraim come and take every Mishnah and open it and try to understand what is the Halachot, why is the Halachot, where we learn it from, and this is what we know as the Gemara. So this is a short what where we came from and where we are today. After the Amoraim, there is a lot more era, yes, Amoraim, Geonim, Rishonim, Achronim, and we are today, Achronim, Achronim, the last of the list. Bezrat Hashem, the Mashiach will come, and this is really going to be the last generation. Okay, so we are on page Lamed Amud Bet, 60 in Yom Gmarot. And this chapter, I decided to start with this chapter and not with other, because this one is very different. Usually the Gemara, it's mostly like argument and machlokot and a lot of talking. But this chapter, it's not about what to do, it's more about how to do. Mostly the Gemara speak about what we need to do, but this here, it's how we need to do. Because we know we need to pray. So this chapter is about praying, about davening, about filah. So now the Gemara, the Amoraim speaks about how to pray and how to get to the tefillah. And it's very easy chapter. So it's good starting. Okay, so say the Gemara, En omdim litpalel, ela mitoch kovet rosh. This is Mishnah start. 16. The fifth chapter. En omdim litpalel, ela mitoch kovet rosh. We're going to read the whole Mishnah and then understand. חסידים הראשונים היו שועים שעה אחת ומתפללים כדי שיחבלו לבם לאביהם שבשמיים. אפילו המלך שואל בשלמה לישיבנו, אפילו נחש כרוך על הכבול לא יפסיק. So these three lines, this is the words of Rabbi Yehuda, הנשיא, in the Mishnah. So we say like this, אין עומדים להתפלל, you're not allowed to stand and pray. It's a, when we say praying, we're speaking about תפילת 18, about עמידה. All the other, it's like the order before or after עמידה. But the עמידה, it's the main part in the tefillah. So, אין עומדים להתפלל, we not stand for praying, אלא מתוך כובד ראש. We need, before we go to the tefillah, we need to be focused and to be more aware and more serious about what we're going to do. Because the tefillah, we have two dimensions in the tefillah. We have one, the joy. And we will understand that in the end of this page that we love HaKadosh Baruch Hu, we have Ahava, and we have Yirah. So we have joy. We're happy to come to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, to our Father, to our King, to our God, and to speak with Him, and to ask Him whatever we need. But we have other dimension that it's Yirah. It's like fear. We understand who we stand in front. We understand when we stand in front of this mighty God, mighty King, and we need to be like more concentrated and humble, of course, and serious about what we're gonna do. So this is called Kovod Rosh. Kovod Rosh is actually when you sometimes you go to meet someone. So you're happy, you're chilling together. So it's nice. But when you have a meeting that you know in this meeting, if I'm gonna be serious in this meeting, I'm gonna have like $1 million from this meeting. So how are you gonna come to this meeting? It's not like you will prepare yourself before, you will come seriously, you come like looking nice and speak nice. So this is Kovod Rosh. Still, you need to stand before Kadosh Baruch Hu in Kovod Rosh. Yeah, modesty. Okay.
Humbleness.
Yeah. Chassidim Arishonim Ayu Shoim Sha'a Achat Mitpalelim. Now they say about Chassidim Arishonim, the first Chassidim. We know about Chassidim now, but the first Chassidim is like 2,000 years ago. That the Mishnah tell us what they used to do. Hayu Shoim Sha'a Achat Mitpalelim. They used to be in Shul, or whatever, whenever they used to pray, and stay there for 1 hour before they come to pray. Why? כדי שיחלו ליבם להביאם שבשמיים. Just sit, without learning, without reading תהילים, nothing. Just sitting and think what we're going to do. We're going to stand now before the King of the King, before הקדוש ברוך הוא. We're going to tell him things. אתה אל הגדול, הגיבור והנורא. We're going to ask him for things. So just be concentrate and serious about what we're going to do. So this is what he used to do. In the Gemara, we're going to see that it's not like only 1 hour. They used to do 1 hour before, 1 hour that tefillah. So the 18 that we used to pray like 2 minutes. So it's going to be, it used to be 1 hour for them and 1 hour after. All of these, כדי שיחבנו ליבם של אביהם שבשמיים, because they need to be concentrated and to make their heart, to put their heart in this תפילה. אפילו המלך שואל בשלמה, לא ישיבנו. Now, say the Mishnah, that when you stand in the תפילה, אפילו המלך שואל בשלמה, even the king, come a king to you, in the middle of the תפילה, you stand and daven, and the king come and say, hi, come, how are you? Not allowed to say even a word, but to answer nothing. He's not here. Even a snake is on your leg, you're not allowed to stop. We'll understand it after in the Gemara, because we know there is halacha of pikuach nefesh. The pikuach nefesh zoche kol haTorah kula. Even in Shabbat, if we have pikuach nefesh, we have a snake in Shabbat, we're allowed to kill him. Even that we're not allowed to kill in Shabbat, but it's pikuach nefesh. So we don't understand in the Gemara what in what condition it's like this. It's this what situation it. So we have here four different halachot in it. So first of all, we need to be concentrated and humble to come to HaKadosh Baruch Hu in humble. And we the Mishnah tell us about the Hasidim HaRishonim, the first Hasidim that they used to be to stay 1 hour before the Tfilah in order to concentrate in the Tfilah. And then even the king come to you and ask you how are you and want to know what with you and ask you something, you're not allowed to say anything. If you don't ask the king, even a snake come to you, you're not allowed to stop. So this is the Gemara. Until here, this is the work of Tanaim. From here, come the Amoraim, few years later, or even a few hundred years, it depends on the time, and ask about this Gemara. Mina lemile. We're starting in the end of the third line. Mina lemile. Ask Gemara. Where you bring this thing from? You say that we need to be like to be in covered rosh before we start the tefillah. Where are you bringing it from? This din. Am Rabbi Elazar, the Amar Kravi, he marat nefesh. Come Rabbi Elazar, one of the Amoraim, and say, well, we learn it from Chana. We know Chana was the wife of Elkanah, the mother of Shmuel Levi. So we're gonna speak this parak. I think is the parak that speak mostly about Chana. Most of the halachot that we're gonna learn for the tefillah that we know today, all the halachot that we know in the tefillah, it's from Chana. So here Rabbi Elazar saying we need to be in kovod rosh, we need to be serious in the tefillah and concentrate in the tefillah. Where we bring it from the pasuk of Chana. Pasuk of Chana say v'hi marat nafesh. So the meaning of the pasuk, and it's about Chana, that she was bitter, her spirit was bitter. Why? Because she didn't have any son, any children, and she asked HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So in this time she was bitter and she prayed to HaKadosh Baruch Hu in this situation. So Rabbi Elazar say from this pasuk of Chana, we understand that when we pray, we need to be like this. Ask the Gemara, Mimai. Well, Why you learn it from Chana? Dilma Chana Shani. Maybe Chana is different. Why is different? De'avat merir ali batuva. She was so bitter because she didn't have any children. Therefore, she prayed like this. But we not like this. So maybe we can pray in different way. So why we bring the source from Chana, this idea from Chana? Ela Amar Rabbi Yossi, Rabbi Yossi, Rabbi Chaina say, we need it from other pasuk, we have other sources. Ve'ani berov chazdecha, ubetecha, eshtachaveh, lechal kodshecha, b'iratecha, say David HaMelech in Tehilim, in the fifth chapter of Tehilim, say David HaMelech, ve'ani berov chazdecha, I will come to your palace in your kindness, and I will bow to your hechal, b'iratecha. How do I will bow? How do I will pray to you, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, in Ira? So Ira, we say it's fear. It's like in serious. It's not something. How do you translate Ira?
Awareness.
Awareness. Okay.
It sounds like fear.
Yeah. So we have two dimensions of Ira. We have fear and we have something to know who I'm standing from beforehand. So here's what David HaMelech say. David HaMelech say, "Ishtachaveh lechal kodshecha b'iratecha." So say, Rabbi Yossi and Rabbi Chanina, From David HaMelech we learn that how should we pray? The same as David HaMelech. David HaMelech pray with Yir'ah. So do we need to pray like this? And the Gemara ask another question. Mimai, why you learn from David? Dilma David Shani. Maybe David is different. Why? The Ava Mitzayir Nafshe Beracha Metuva. Because David HaMelech, we know David HaMelech for a long time. The old Tehillim is David HaMelech. And we see all of the Tehillim, it's praying and praise and pray to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So David HaMelech is different because he used to pray and used to stand before HaKadosh Baruch Hu a lot more than we do. So maybe he's different and he prayed with Yirah, but we don't need to. So we need another pasuk for this. Elam Rabbi Yoshua Belevi Meach. Say Rabbi Yoshua Belevi, we have another pasuk for this. All of this learning, we want to understand where this halakha that we need to stand in the tefillah mikoved rosh, in awareness, in the to be concentrated in the tefillah, we need to understand where it's from. Because in our religion, Baruch Hashem, we're not like a monkey. Do and that's it. We want to understand where it's from. So you said halakha, very nice. I want to understand what is the source. So we're still searching for the source. So say Rabbi Yoshua Belevi Meacha, we have another pasuk also in Tehillim. Ishtachavu LaHashem Be'adrat Kodesh. So there the pasuk say we need to bow before HaKadosh Baruch Hu Be'adrat Kodesh. So Hadra is Hadar, it's mean like glory, beautiful. In holy glory. So this is what David HaMelech says in Tehillim. Come the Gemara and say, Al tikri behadrat, ela becherdat. Don't read. We have the same word, but we just change one letter. We change from hey hadrat to cherdat, and then it's not glory. It's not beautiful. It's become cherda. It's like fear. It's like awareness. It's very similar to ira. So say Rabbi Yoshua Melevi, we take this pasuk. Ishtachavu LaHashem Be'adrat Kodesh. We need to bow and pray to HaKadosh Baruch Hu in Hadrat Kodesh. It's actually in Cherdat Kodesh, in awareness, in fear. Say Gemara Mimai. You take a pasuk and change the word, then you say, okay, from there we learn that we need to be serious in the tefillah. Don't change it. The pasuk is like this. Why you change? Mimai. Dilma le'olam ma'chadrat mamash. Maybe it's really hadrat. In the Tehillim, it's to say, Ishtachavu LaHashem Be'adrat Kodesh. It's mean to hadrat Kodesh, to be beautiful and to look nice in the tefillah. Likewise, Ki Ad Rav Yehuda. We have a story about Rav Yehuda. The Rav Yehuda v'metzay nafshe v'ad armas. We have a story about Rav Yehuda that before he go to daven, before he go to shul, he used to come, stand in front of the mirror, and make sure he look nice. He have a good clothing, clean clothing. His hair, his beard, it's look nice. And then he come to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. He say, I go in front of the king. I don't want to go like straight from the walk with my dirty clothing. I will go. I will make sure that I look nice. And then I go to the tefillah. So this is called Hadrat Kodesh. You need to bow and pray to HaKadosh Baruch Hu and Hadrat look nice. And then come to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So don't change the word from hadrat to cherdat, from glory to fear, to awareness. Ela, so we don't have a source. Ela amar Rav Nachman bar Yitzchak me'acha. So say Rav Nachman bar Yitzchak, we have another pasuk. And this pasuk, you're going to stay with him. Ivdu et Hashem beira, v'gilu beirada. So this pasuk, it's also from Tehillim. We have three psukim from Tehillim that we need to work and serve HaKadosh Baruch Hu be'ira, in fear, in awareness, ve'gilu birada, enjoy with trembling. Trembling is good, it's like rad, yeah? And joy when you tremble. Okay? So, from the beginning of the pasuk, we understand, if you do it Hashem, be'ira, how do you serve Hashem? How do you work the work of Hashem? Be'ira, with fear, with awareness. And this work, the work of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, what is the work? Tefillah. Because nowadays we don't have Bet HaMikdash, unfortunately. And Bet HaMikdash used to bring sacrifice. So this was the Avodah, the work of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. But now we don't have. We have only Avodah Shebalev, the work in the heart. So what is Avodah Shebalev? It's Tfilah. Okay. Now, after we understand where this halacha comes from, that we need to serve Hashem Be'ir'a, now we want to understand the end of the Pasuk. Ve'gilu bir'ada. We say we need to be joyful and tremble. How it works together. When you joy, you're not tremble. It's not re'ada. So ask the Gemara, Mai ve'gilu bir'ada? What is gilu bir'ada? Or this, decide, or this, or this. Amar avada bar matna, amar rabba, b'makom gila sham te'er adah. So say avada bar matna in the name of rabba, is rav rabba, b'makom gila in the place of gila, in the place of joy and happiness, sham te'er adah. Because in this world, you're not allowed to be fully happy or fully joyful. You need to have a place for re'adah, for tremble, to understand that it's not all like not all supposed to be joyful and happy. Abaye, now a story about Abaye. Abaye avayati kamei de rabba. Abaye used to he sat in front of his rabbi, of his rabbi, rabba. Chazde de ava kabad achtuva. He saw him that he's very, very happy. Too much. Amar vigilo beradaptiv. How do you so happy? The Pasuk say, Vegilu Berada, even if you're happy, even if you're joyful, even if you're in Simcha, you need to be in Rada, a little bit of trouble, and you stand in front of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Amar le, ana tefillin manachem. He said, no. In my situation, it's okay. Why? Because I wasn't tefillin. If I weren't tefillin, say Rashi, this is a witness that I'm serving HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So why we not allowed to be so happy? Of course, we need to be happy to serve HaKadosh Baruch Hu b'simcha, of course. But not fill our mouth with joy, with laughing. So say Rabbah, right now I'm putting tefillin, I'm wearing tefillin. So this the tefillin is a witness for me that I'm serving HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So I allow this time to be happy so much. Rabbi Irmiah, another story about Rabbi Irmiah, Avayatim Kamei de Rabbi Zeira. Now Rabbi Irmiah used to sit in front of his rabbi, Rabbi Zeira. Chazye de'ava kabad achtuva. Also, he saw him that he very, very happy. It's not only happy, it's badach, it's like b'dicha, it's like laughing. Amar le, b'choletzev yeh mutarti. In every sadness, it will be a benefit. So this is what Shlomo HaMelech said, that there is a sadness that is bringing benefit. It's, of course, it's not sadness of a depression or something like this. It's sadness of serious. You need to be serious sometimes and you have a benefit from this. So how come that you're so, so happy? A little bit less, a little bit of sadness of seriousness. Amar le, again, the same answer. Ana tefillin manachem. I wearing tefillin. And if I wearing tefillin, we have one interpretation. What is wearing tefillin? That Akadosh, that this is a witness that I'm serving Akadosh Baruch Hu, that I'm in front of Akadosh Baruch Hu. And the second interpretation is that I'm doing a mitzvah now. I'm performing this huge mitzvah of tefillin. How come I'm not going to be so happy? I'm wearing tefillin. I'm very happy because of this mitzvah. Okay, we're going to then two more stories and then we're going to finish for today. Mar Brei de Ravina Ava Didula Le Brei. Mar, he was the son of Ravina, he did a wedding for his son. Chazanu Le Rabbanan de Ava Kabad Chetuva. So Rabbanan, all the rabbis, all the guests there in the wedding, they were so very happy in there. Aiti Kasa Demuk Rabat Arba Me'azuze Betavar Kamayu Ve'yatzivu. So what he did? Took a glass of a white glass that it cost 400 zuz, so very, very expensive glass, and he threw it in front of them. It broke, and everyone saw this. And of course, you see this lost, and you become serious and a little bit sad. So Ravashi also made a wedding for his son. Chazanu Rabbanan de Abu Kabat Chetuva. He saw also Rabbanan that he saw the rabbis that used to be been very very happy. Ati ata kaisi kasa de zugit achivata v'tavar kamayu v'yatzavu. So he also brought another cup of a white glass. It's very expensive glass, and it broke in front of them, and they become like more serious. Of course, again, I will say, we need to be happy. We need to be with joy, to serve HaKadosh Baruch Hu with joy, but there is a level of joy that it's too much. And we need to understand, first of all, in this time, don't have a time like that, so we need to be a little bit less happy than in the time of the Mikdash, because we need to remember the Mikdash, and this is the reason that we break the glass in the wedding, because we want to remember the Mikdash and to understand that in every joy that we have, in every happiness that we have, in every occasion that we have, we need to understand that we serve a Kadosh Baruch Hu even now, and that we don't have the Mikdash. Now, the last story also about wedding. Amru l'Rabbanan l'Rav Amnun Azute v'ilu lo demar b'rei d'Ravina. So it was a wedding for Mar Brei d'Ravina, Mar the son of Ravina. And Rabbanan came to Rav Amnun Azuti, probably was a singer, and they told him, please sing something. Lishrel an Mar, there is a wedding, sing something. Amar Lehu, what is singing to them? Vailan de Mitnan, Vailan de Mitnan. What was the lyrics of this song? Oy vey, we're going to die. We're gonna die. Amrele anan mana nebatrach. Okay, very strange song, but what we need to say after you? You know, there is song that I say a sentence and you repeat something else. So why? What we need to say after you? Amar lehem ei Torah vei mitzvah demagnu ala. You will say, where is the Torah and the mitzvot? They will protect us. So actually, in this song, he don't come to depress everyone and say, that's it, we're going to die, no more reason and taste for living. No. He came there, I saw it today, very, very nice. He came there and told them, this world, it's not the goal of life. Of course, this world, it's like a place for to pass. It's like the hallway before we go into the great place of Olam Haba. So he told them, "Vailan demitnan, vailan demitnan, you're gonna die." And then you will say, "Hey Torah ve'el mitzvah demagnu alan." In this world, of course, it's right. We're gonna die in a few years. We're not Hashem after 120 years. But in this world, we have a work. We have Torah and we have mitzvot that they will protect us in the world to come, Be'ezrat Hashem. So this is what he tells them. Another thing that I saw, that when we're going to finish with this, that he told them, it was in the wedding. So he came to the Chatan and Kala, to the bride and the groom, and tell them, this world, it's not everything. You need to understand. You need to have Shalom Bayit. This world, it's, you know, the life, it's passing by, and you can't argue on every little thing, every physical thing. You need to understand that the main thing in the world, in this world, it's Torah and mitzvot. Part of the Torah and mitzvot is Shalom Bayit. Kadosh Baruch Hu, his name is Shalom. So you need to keep the Shalom, the peace in your house in order to succeed in your marriage. So this is what I saw in the, that he came to tell them in the wedding, because the song looked very, very strange. But when you understand what he mean, what meant in the song from the end of the song, Hey Torah Ve'im Tzadim Adonu Alam, then you understand what is meaning. Baruch Adonai Le'olam, Amen Ve'amen. Baruch. This shiur on Abi, on Ado Ashkava, Malachim Al-Kol B'Otah, Malachos Ve'achon Malachim Al-Yubi, Zohar Shabbat 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 Shabbat